Now we will discuss about the vascular and nerve supply of the larynx and lymphatic drainage of the larynx. First, about the arterial supply of the larynx. The larynx, it is supplied by the branches of superior and inferior thyroid arteries. So above the level of the vocal folds, the larynx, it is mainly supplied by the superior laryngeal branches of the superior thyroid artery. And this superior laryngeal branch, it pierces the thyroid membrane along with the internal laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve. While below the level of the vocal folds, the larynx will be mainly supplied by the inferior laryngeal branches of the inferior thyroid artery. But there will be always a rich anastomosis between the branches of the same side and also with the branches of the opposite side. And remanglotids will have a dual blood supply both from the superior and inferior thyroid arteries. So blood arterial supply of the larynx above the level of the vocal folds, it is mainly by the superior laryngeal branch of superior thyroid artery, while below the level of vocal folds, it is mainly by the inferior laryngeal branch of inferior thyroid artery. The venous drainage of the larynx, it is above the level of the vocal folds, it is mainly by the superior laryngeal veins, which are the tributaries of superior thyroid veins, draining into the internal jugular vein. While below the level of vocal folds, the inferior laryngeal veins, they will drain into inferior thyroid veins, which are mainly draining into the left brachiocephalic vein. So venous drainage above the level of vocal folds, it is by the tributaries draining into superior thyroid vein and into internal jugular vein, while below the level of vocal folds, through the inferior thyroid vein, the larynx, it will drain into left brachiocephalic vein. The nerve supply of the larynx, first about its sensory nerve supply. So above the level of the vocal folds, the mucosa of the larynx, it is mainly supplied by the internal laryngeal nerve. The internal laryngeal nerve, it is a branch from the superior laryngeal nerve of vagus nerve. This superior laryngeal branch of vagus nerve, it divides into two branches, an internal and external laryngeal nerve. The internal laryngeal nerve, along with superior laryngeal vessels, will pierce the thyroid membrane and it will supply mainly the mucosa of the larynx above the level of vocal folds, while this external laryngeal branch will supply the cricothyroid muscle. So mucosa of the larynx above the level of vocal folds, it is supplied by the internal laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve, while below the level of vocal folds, the mucosa of the larynx, it is mainly supplied by the recurrent laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve. So this is the sensory nerve supply of the larynx. So above the level of vocal folds by internal laryngeal and below the level of vocal folds by recurrent laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve. While the muscles of the larynx, all the muscles of the larynx, they are supplied by the recurrent laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve, except for the cricothyroid muscle, which is supplied by the external laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve. So the recurrent laryngeal branch of vagus nerve will supply all the muscles except cricothyroid, and also it will supply the mucosa below the level of the vocal folds. Now about the lymphatic drainage of the larynx. The lymphatics of the larynx above the vocal folds, they will mainly drain into the upper deep cervical group of lymph nodes, and the lymphatic vessels, they will travel along the superior laryngeal vessels. While below the level of vocal folds, the lymphatics, they will mainly drain into the lower deep cervical group of lymph nodes, but few of these lymphatics, they will also pass along the pretracheal and pre-laryngeal group of lymph nodes. Here, the vocal cords, they will act as a clear-cut watershed line with a very few or no lymphatics. So this is about the blood supply, nerve supply, and lymphatic drainage of the larynx.